one of the different comic book
publishers. Oh my gosh, wait!
And first I'll give you a little history of how comic superheroes started. The first superhero in the comic book was Superman, which in 1938 was created by two teenagers, Jerry Siegel and Joe Shuster, who created Superman. And years later, I was actually hired to work on that comic book. The very first comic book I worked on was Superman. So I'm going to draw Superman, and I'll show you how I start drawing the figure when I'm doing a comic book panel. So Superman, again, was created in 1938. And that was by Jerry Siegel and Joe Shuster. And I always start from the top, and I judge how many heads fall off the character. So this is a pretty tall character. The superheroes are about 11 to 12 heads high. So if you take the head and multiply it times 12, that's how tall a superhero is, if you're drawing it to the head. So, okay, now I put in first middle part of it, and I already drew the head. Now I'll do an action pose with Superman. And I think it's a lot of flying. And just, I always start in pencil first. When you get into the comic book business, a lot of times there are two artists, a penciler and an inker. So there's two different artists very often, in addition to the colorer who does the color work on the comic book. Still, a lot of artists work in brush and ink or pen and ink. The coloring now is done digitally quite a bit. So it's done with the computer, the color. And when I'm doing the comic panels and the comic book, I just walk through put in the colors first like this. And then I'm going to add all the details on it. So here we are. The first step in drawing the comic superhero. Now I'm going to make the lines more definite by adding the details and doing cleaner lines. Okay, now we'll start with the face first. Again, it was started in 1938 by two teenage artists, an artist and a writer. What I'm going to do is add some color to the studio. And again, the finished comics, when I worked on them, the color was done with the computer. And with pastel, you can just move it with your fingers like this. Now this started what was called the Golden Age of comics. The Golden Age of comic books started in 1938, and the Golden Age is considered 1938 to 1950. So there's all different eras when different comic books and comic characters started. So the big year was 1938. Batman was the second character to come along, and that was the following year, 1939, by three creators. Bob Kane was the creator of Batman, along with Bill Finger and Jerry Robinson. Jerry Robinson created the Joker, and he also created several other characters, including Robin. Robin is actually based on Robin Hood. The character is based on Robin Hood from the Legend of Robin Hood. Usually I sign my last name. Okay, and there's Superman. And let's see, we'll give this out to somebody in the audience who'd like to have it. So as I mentioned, that was the start of comic book superheroes, 1938. In 1939, Batman was created by Bob Kane and the two other artists I mentioned. Batman, we're going to do next. And I worked on several of the Batman comic books for DC Comics, and also some of the newspaper comic strips too. Okay, Batman has changed quite a bit over the years. When I worked on this particular character, it was in the 1980s. And so he developed from 1938 through the 80s, now to the present age, which is the modern age, called his comic book. And Frank Miller, who did the Dark Knight comic book, changed the look quite a bit. So Batman keeps evolving and becoming different looking. This is the 1980s version, which I worked on. And Robin is based on Robin Hood. You notice the costume is quite a bit like Robin Hood and his outfit. This is Batman. And this was based on a movie actually called The Bat, and it was also based on Superman. So Bob Kane combined movie The Bat and Superman, and Batman was created. And when they created Batman, it was quite a different concept because he's not from another planet. He's from Earth, unlike Superman. So he came from a different origin than Superman. And he's actually human and not from another planet. So this is Batman. We'll add some color to Batman. And the outfit is, keeps changing over the years, especially with movies and motion pictures and television animation and so forth. So this is about the 1980s. Batman when I worked on it. And quite a number of artists have worked on Batman, including one of my teachers, Dick Giordano, who was one of my art teachers when I was starting out. He also worked on that. And here's Batman, also I'm going to sign this one. DC Comics started with the first superhero, Superman, followed by Batman. The next stage was the Golden Age from 1938 to 1950. Around 1941, because of the war, a new comic book character came and started first with Timely Comics, which then became Marvel Comics. So Marvel Comics, started a character named Captain America.
Yeah, Captain America!
And that was a very patriotic character because of the war. By Jack Kirby and Joe Simon, who created Captain America.
you gotta take one.
Yeah,
right? This is a trademark shield. Move the colors in. Back then, when the comics started, the color was still painted by hand. Now the color work is done digitally, so it's done with a computer program. America. Here's a Captain America fan back here.
Thank you so much.